Over the years, there have been many debates across many fandoms and franchises. Would you join the Sith or would you join the Jedi? Who is the better brother? Mario or Luigi? Digimon or Pokemon? And now one great question has plagued our minds since 2018. Who is the better Sensei? Is it Daniel LaRusso or Johnny Lawrence? Well, what if I told you that Johnny is closer to being a Sensei much like Mr. Miyagi was than Daniel is?
Hey yo, what the f-
Okay, put down the pitchforks. Let me just make one thing perfectly clear. Neither Johnny or Daniel are the villains in this saga. We can all agree that no matter who you side with, they aren't perfect but good men who have their flaws. Even Mr. Miyagi made mistakes in his lifetime, but this is what makes the characters so great and relatable because they are human. If these characters were perfect, we'd find them and the show boring. Johnny himself said it best. Life isn't black and white, but more often than not, it is gray. This is an overall character analysis slash breakdown mixed with some theory and supporting facts. We'll dive into the first topic to get the elephant in the room out of the way and something to objectively compare Johnny and Daniel, their flaws. Let's start with Johnny. I'll even keep score for both sides. We're going to look at their mistakes in chronological order from the Karate Kid anthology up to the current season 2 of Cobra Kai. All the way back in Karate Kid 1, Johnny is still hurt after he and Allie broke up. He confirms this when retelling the story to Miguel in the episode Molting. He sees Daniel talking to Allie and goes to try to talk to Allie at the beach party. Here's where collectively Johnny makes his first mistake. By disrespecting Allie's wishes to be left alone, this leads him to breaking the radio in frustration, shoving Daniel out of jealousy which instigates the fight, and beating down Daniel. Now Daniel did attempt to strike him and Johnny swept Daniel twice out of defense, but ultimately Johnny did instigate the fight and struck him down. When school starts, Johnny sees Daniel talking to Allie at school on the field. His jealousy gets the better of him and he gets Bayou to sweep him on purpose during the game of soccer. On his way home on a different night, after seeing Daniel in the Cobra Kai dojo earlier that day wanting to learn karate, Johnny instigates once again when he and his friends cut Daniel off, causing him to fall down a hill. When Daniel visits the country club to pick up Allie, Johnny notices Daniel spying on him and Allie dancing through the kitchen window and kisses Allie to make Daniel jealous. Ironically enough, this is the last major mistake Johnny makes until the tournament, where he fights dirty and attacks Daniel's bad leg illegally with an elbow. Let's fast forward to Cobra Kai, as we know outside of the intro in Karate Kid 2, Johnny doesn't run into Daniel until many years later. Between the original trilogy and Cobra Kai, we know he walked out on Robbie, causing their strained relationship. We see him spray painting Daniel's billboard in a drunken rage, upset that he let Miguel down against his bullies at the start of the Cobra Kai Never Dies episode. Fast forward to Quiver, he is very hard on the new recruits and new students by picking on their physical appearances to the point where they quit on him and in the case of Dimitri, gets him to strike first so he can counterattack. As mentioned before, he tells Miguel about Allie and Daniel in the episode of Molting, but purposely leaves out the parts where he instigated the fight with Daniel and also bullied him into falling down the hill. At the All Valley Tournament in the episode Mercy, the influence of the old Cobra Kai starts to creep in as he tells Miguel to perform the crane kick as a subtle jab in front of Daniel. After realizing the hollow victory of winning the tournament, we start off season 2 with a mistake that greatly cost him down the line, leading Kreese back into the dojo. In the episode of Back in Black, although intended to be a way to punish the students for slacking off and teaching them to move forward, he orders the students to climb into the cement truck and to spin the concrete mixer, putting them in a very dangerous situation. In the following episode, Fire and Ice, Johnny responds to Daniel's commercial by purposely calling out Miyagi-Do's free karate, lame meditation bullshit you get what you pay for in his own commercial. Also in the same episode, we see Johnny and the Cobra Kai hijacking the finale of Miyagi-Do's performance so they can get people to join their dojo and shift students joining in their favor. In the episode All In, Johnny is looking for Robbie and shows up to LaRusso Auto. He physically assaults Anoush, trying to get the details of where Robbie is. In the same episode, Johnny tells Carmen about the rivalry he and Daniel have after sobering up, once again leaving out important details. And finally in the episode No Mercy, Johnny starts another fight with Daniel, though out of defense for Daniel forcing his way in. Either way, the fight truly starts when Johnny kicks Daniel, so we'll chalk it up and we'll cover more details on later for key moments like these. Now I know what you're thinking. How can I base my argument that Johnny is better with all of these mistakes? Well, we haven't begun to list Daniel's mistakes yet, so buckle up for round 2. Back in Karate Kid 1, although Johnny did instigate the initial fight at the start of the movie, Daniel did instigate the Halloween fight by placing the water hose in the stall that Johnny was in. Daniel's arrogance, which we'll see a lot more of on this list, gets the better of him as he taunts the Cobra Kai in front of Allie. Even though it was Mr. Miyagi who requested the Cobra Kai not to antagonize him in his defense, Daniel now becomes the aggressor in this particular moment. Daniel's arrogance gets the best of him again when Miyagi tries to teach him how to punch, but he doesn't stay focused and ignores Miyagi's instructions to stop. In Karate Kid 2, when Miyagi is showing him how to use the drum technique, Daniel misses the first time and Miyagi says that they'll try again tomorrow and to get out of the water. Daniel defies this instruction and releases another hook to practice the drum technique, almost injuring himself in the process and also disobeying the sensei's orders. In Karate Kid 3, while opening up their bonsai shop, Daniel wants to compete in the tournament to defend his title. This is brought up a few times, though Miyagi repeatedly tells him that he has nothing to prove and that he will not sign the entry form. Daniel protests that this is the best thing to happen to him, but Miyagi says that karate doesn't mean anything to defend a plastic trophy. Although going against his better judgment, Daniel still feels he has to compete in the tournament due to being forced to by Mike Barnes, so he enters anyway. Because of this, he also fails to talk to Mr. Miyagi about getting more money after the bonsai shop is wrecked. Mr. Miyagi had a plan to sell his truck while Daniel went and retrieved the bonsai tree from Devil's Cauldron without talking to Mr. Miyagi, and also causing the bonsai tree to be broken. He also lies to Mr. Miyagi about training with Mr. Silver, and even gets into a heated confrontation and yells at Mr. Miyagi, and might I add, Miyagi is letting him stay there for free when the apartment Daniel and his mom lived in is being sold. When Daniel and Jessica are at the dance, an insistent patron wants to dance with Jessica, and after being told no by both Daniel and Jessica, he shoves Daniel and Daniel lands the first strike, breaking his nose. Now let's fast forward once again to Cobra Kai. Although playing it off as a joke, Daniel's arrogance once again shines through as he gloats in front of Louie and Anoush about his match with Johnny. After Kyler tells Daniel that some guy at the mini mall jumped him and his friends, Daniel goes to confront Johnny. Though Johnny is willing to be civil, Daniel swears that they aren't done, making him a hypocrite to refuse to listen to Johnny when minutes before he said he was not there to rehash the past. In Escalito, when they run into each other again, Daniel refuses to believe and listen to Johnny once again, criticizing Johnny's belief of the lessons working, showing that he sees himself as the better person without fault and tells Johnny to get off school property. In Cobra Kai Never Dies, Daniel goes to confront Tom Cole about the billboard. Although Miyagi typically has taught Daniel to take the high road, as seen as in Karate Kid 3, and Tom Cole deserved it, he nonetheless kicked the tea out of Tom's hand. In the episode Counterbalance, Daniel, almost taking out a page of Terry Silver's book, enacts a convoluted plot that causes Cobra Kai's rent and the other stores in the strip mall to go up, by telling Armand that he's undercharging for rent for the strip mall, and although he brags about this to Amanda, she criticizes him for doing this. In the episode All Valley, when Johnny tries to have Cobra Kai reinstated, Daniel once again refuses to believe that Johnny is being sincere, still harboring a grudge because of what Mike Barnes, John Kreese, and Terry Silver did to him in 1985. In the episode Molting, this grudge once again surfaces when he forbids Samantha to associate with anybody from Cobra Kai, putting a strain on her relationship with Miguel, assuming them to be all bad apples, contrary to Johnny, who advised Miguel to be careful. He also indirectly influences Louis' decision to destroy Johnny's car with the aid of his new biker friends. After the All Valley Tournament in Mercy, Daniel still does not accept defeat and plans on pushing Cobra Kai out of the valley when he takes Robbie back to Miyagi-Do Dojo, hypocritically going against what he told Robbie before to find balance. In the episode Back in Black, although Daniel has a responsibility to tell Johnny about Robbie's situation, he forgoes this due to his anger upon seeing Kreese with Johnny and refuses to tell Johnny the truth about Robbie. He also subtly references and insults the Cobra Kai Dojo in a commercial in the episode Fire and Ice, also making the commercial without asking Amanda. In the episode All In, although Kreese was ultimately responsible for instructing Hawk and others to trash Miyagi-Do, Daniel shows up to the dojo to confront Johnny, once again not believing Johnny is telling the truth and begins to not only poach students, but to subtly goad Johnny to a fight and also insult him in front of his own students. Although promising Amanda at the start of the season to be able to balance both Miyagi-Do and LaRusso Otto, he ultimately does not keep this promise and ends up upsetting Amanda at the end of the episode Lull. In the episode Pulpo, Daniel still acts snobby and arrogant at the dinner date, especially with Johnny's choice of drink and the way he eats. And finally, last but not least, in the episode No Mercy, although Daniel was concerned about Sam's well-being, he still broke into Johnny's apartment even though Johnny told him to calm down and cool off, starting the fight with Johnny. Now, I'm sure some of you may begin to argue about what each sensei stands for motto-wise. I'm totally open to discuss that as well. Miyagi-Do's number one rule is that karate is for defense only, with this philosophy supported by the ideals of focus, inner peace, and balance. Cobra Kai, on the other hand, focuses on offense. Strike first, strike hard, no mercy. This is where the line starts to gray. I'm willing to admit from the overall standpoint of philosophy, Miyagi-Do has the better ideals. It has a history of doing wonders for its students, whether it's Mr. Miyagi, Daniel LaRusso, Julie Pierce, or Robbie King. However, two of these students, despite being firm believers and practitioners of this philosophy, don't always stay on the straight and narrow. The obvious and primary example of this is when Miguel remembered Johnny telling him the difference between mercy and honor and decided not to seriously injure Robbie. Robbie, not focused and out of balance, attacked Miguel and critically injured him. Daniel LaRusso serves as another example of a student not following the philosophy, doing things such as not being able to forgive Johnny and still holding a grudge, using his influence to raise the prices of rent in a strip mall to shut down Cobra Kai and not think of the others' rent in the same area, poaching students while insulting their sensei, and numerous other instances of his hothead behavior, which he admits himself while visiting Mr. Miyagi. These are all examples of him not only not practicing what he preaches, but also clearly lost and confused without Mr. Miyagi present. Unless you're willing to take these lessons to heart and practice them, you can still be a bad student and a bad teacher. This is where Johnny Lawrence has the upper hand. Though he is passing on the ideals of strike first, strike hard, no mercy, he has learned not only from his past of having a ruthless teacher like Kreese, but also having to veer his students back to the straight and narrow, realizing that he has to set example and be more clear on these principles. More on that later. The Cobra Kai principles can be applied positively to everyday life. For example, it would make sense to strike first if you're playing a game against a friend and you see an opportunity to get the upper hand. It would be okay to strike hard if you wanted to really pass an exam and you're focusing on studying to get the grade you want. Even no mercy can be applied in a positive manner if we think about it as a synonym for the phrase give it your all. Putting no mercy behind everything you do, whether it's winning that game, acing that test, and training hard, would work as a means of motivation. In fact, even though he is obviously Cobra Kai and is also known to be a hothead, it is Johnny who remains focused and or calm when Daniel confronts him at the dojo about Kyler, in the school passing out flyers, at the All Valley Conference, at the hardware store, at the convenience store twice, at the dojo again after Miyagi-Do is trashed, and having to share a table at the restaurant. It is Johnny who reprimands his students for fighting dirty, something he regrets the last time he competed in the All Valley tournament, teaching them to move forward and to show mercy, not to think with their fists but with their mind, because life is not black and white. Now let's move on to the final topic of this video and to the meat of the analysis, the similarities that Johnny Lawrence and Narayoshi Miyagi share, and how Johnny, not Daniel, is closer to being a sensei like Miyagi. There is also one thing I want to make clear. There is a huge difference between a callback to the source material. For example, Tori saying her name was with a Y as a nod to Allie with an I, Daniel teaching Robbie how to trim bonsai trees, and Miguel wearing a skeleton costume provided by Johnny. Those are different from things that are deliberately put in by the writers for character growth and comparison, which is what we'll be focusing on. As I mentioned above, breaking down Johnny and Daniel's faults, Miyagi himself also made some mistakes. Back in Karate Kid 1 while training out on a lake, Daniel asked Miyagi about his childhood. Miyagi stated that he got into plenty of fights and hated fighting, also stating that although he knew karate, someone always knows more. While Miyagi-Do's primary philosophy is that karate is for defense only, I'm inclined to believe that even a few fights that Miyagi were in are the ones that he started. Again, no one is perfect, and similar to how he is there for Daniel, Miyagi's father was there to keep him grounded and to help him learn from his mistakes. What was at least one fight that he started, you ask? The one with Sato. Now, we know that Yukie was arranged to be married to Sato, but Miyagi fell in love with Yukie and dishonored Sato by announcing his love for her in front of the village. Sato challenged Miyagi to a fight to the death, but Miyagi did not want to fight his best friend and instead moved to the United States. Miyagi and Sato did not meet again until Karate Kid 2, however, I think we can assume that while fleeing Okinawa, Miyagi had to defend himself at least once against Sato, or maybe Miyagi knocked out Sato without seriously injuring him. This caused a strain with his old friend. After all, Miyagi was the one who asked his father to teach both him and his childhood friend Sato. Miyagi also explains to Daniel before he leaves for Okinawa that the biggest lesson he learned from all this is to never put passion before principle, because even if you won, you still lost. Miyagi could have made the decision emotionally to fight Sato and be with Yukie, but logically, he did not want to choose to hurt either Sato or Yukie. In fact, in both a funny and serious way, this is how a lot of fights start in the anthology. Girl gets involved, fight. Girl gets involved, fight. Girl gets involved, fight. Girl gets involved, fight. This lesson about passion and principles, Johnny learns the hard way as well, although in a different situation. After wanting Cobra Kai to succeed at the All Valley despite all the setbacks, it's a hollow victory. Miguel is now corrupted, Robbie is hurt, and Johnny is almost back at square one, feeling like that he has failed. Let's take a look at some more comparisons with Johnny and Miyagi. Although in different circumstances, Johnny and Mr. Miyagi both lost a son but had the chance to be a father to someone else. Johnny, stricken by the death of his mother and in a drunken depression, abandons Robbie and has a strained relationship with his son up until season 2. What we don't know about Johnny's situation is how many attempts he's made between Robbie's birth and at the start of Cobra Kai to make it right, but from the context of several conversations, Johnny still wants the best for his son. One of the best things to ever happen to him is Miguel. He teaches Miguel in a variety of ways, whether it's karate, personal growth, dating advice, the list goes on. Mr. Miyagi lost not only his son, but his wife due to complications at birth. Both of them were held at the Manzanar internment camp while Mr. Miyagi was away during World War II. No doctors were around to help, and this haunts Mr. Miyagi for years. He is, however, able to pass on things he learned from his own father to Daniel LaRusso. Also helped in a variety of ways through karate, personal growth, dating advice, etc., Johnny and Miyagi are also both handymen. Miyagi is able to incorporate this into his karate training with Daniel. While Johnny does it purely for work and to fix up his dojo, he does incorporate this in some form for Miguel to help fix the dojo, which Daniel was also doing too. One very interesting thing to note is that although Cobra Kai's principles are rooted in offense, Johnny in several instances, although may have landed the first hit, did not strike first and use karate for defense. Not only for himself but others as well, as Daniel notes after the mall fight that defense only also applies to defend others. In Ace Degenerate, at first Johnny minds his own business and doesn't get involved when Kyler and his gang pick on Miguel. In another similarity that Miyagi notes that it's not a good idea for him to get involved in others' affairs, Johnny also says this after taking Miguel home after the Halloween dance. But that changes when they shove Miguel into Johnny's car. Kyler, like Johnny in 1984, shoves the person he is bullying to start a fight. But Johnny begins to quickly decimate the gang, very much like Miyagi did to defend and save Daniel during Halloween in 1984. In Molting, Louie and his biker friends begin to smash up Johnny's car as a message from Daniel LaRusso. Johnny has a right to defend himself and his property and is also outnumbered, not to mention Louie wields a baseball bat in this fight. This is similar to how Mr. Miyagi defends his property from racists in Karate Kid 1, when politely asking for them to move their bottles, has to demonstrate what he can do to them if they don't comply. During the visit to a bar with his old Cobra Kai buddies and take a right, he and Tommy go to grab next on a pool table where the patron not only insults them, but tries to put his hand on Johnny, who again is in the right to defend himself. This is very similar to how all fights with Mr. Miyagi would go. Miyagi would always counter the opponent's move when they would attempt to strike him first. In Glory of Love, Johnny overhears Graham tell his friend that he plans to hit and quit Carmen. To defend her honor, Johnny confronts Graham about it, who responds by trying to put his hands on him, and at this point, Johnny simply counterattacks and neutralizes him. In the apartment fight at No Mercy, it is Daniel who lands the first hit by kicking the door into Johnny's apartment. Johnny now is defending not only himself but Sam and Robbie. Again, defense means also defending others. Another huge hint is musical cues. This applies in a variety of ways. Mr. Miyagi has some very distinct motifs, one being a melody of higher pitched flute notes. The melody in question I'm referring to is at the beginning of the tracks Onto Miyagi's, The Pact, and Japanese Sander from the Karate Kid 1 soundtrack. This theme also makes a reprise in the Cobra Kai Season 2 in the song An Old Friend, which plays when Daniel sees another fisherman who reminds him of Mr. Miyagi. Another motif is the melody with the lower flute notes, accompanied by what you could call a bass line of violin and string instruments. This melody is the basis of the song Fish and Train, but either the flute melody and or the string bass line also make appearances in Miyagi Rattles Bones, Miyagi Intercedes, The Pact, Japanese Sander, and Paint the Fence. This specific melody is also part of the song The Wrong Path from the Cobra Kai Season 1 soundtrack. Daniel has two very similar motifs in Cobra Kai. A different flute melody which is the basis of Miyagi Memories, Miyagi's Tomb, and Bonsai Lessons to name a few. And a string bassline melody variation which is the basis for the intro of Miyagi-Do, a core melody in Balance, and also The Wrong Path. Why does this matter? Well, we know what Johnny's recurring motif is, the guitar in Ace Degenerate, which for example reprises in Black Paint on a White Wall in The New Champion. The New Champion also features another prominent guitar melody which could very easily be Miguel's motif, as this melody is the basis for Father and Son, which also reprises in You Earned It, Voicemail, and also The New Champion. In fact, Johnny and Miguel share motifs in music just like Miyagi and Daniel. But what also sticks out to me is that in the song Strike First, which plays during Johnny's fight with Kyler's gang, one instrument sticks out of a couple times during the track, a flute which very quickly and distinctly plays the last few notes of Miyagi's second motif featured in Fish and Train. This can't be a callback, and let's say if it is, why would the writers put it in with Johnny's music and not Daniel's? This is a very subtle nod by the composers and writers noting that Johnny and Miyagi are different but same. Johnny, as mentioned before in the Faults and Flaws breakdown, does something a lot more than Daniel has trouble doing but what Mr. Miyagi taught him through the principles of inner peace and focus, taking the high road and stay calm. Daniel and Johnny at times can both be hotheads, but you would imagine that Daniel, having trained with Miyagi for many years up until Miyagi's passing and where Cobra Kai begins, would have taken the lessons to heart a little more, especially with the principle of balance, but yet has had more outbursts and strays away from staying focused. Johnny over time has learned to stay calm in situations and take the high road like Miyagi would. For example, Miyagi is very cool and collected in situations such as being confronted by Kreese and Silver after their fight when they trash talk Miyagi and Daniel, especially with the statement, "Come, we waste our time here." With the bonsai shop being wrecked, and also with Daniel being visibly upset over not learning anything chore-wise at first. Johnny's more willing to follow this advice as it was given to him, by Miguel for the All Valley Conference meeting and also by Carmen for the next time Daniel confronts Johnny. Johnny says he won't give in to anger and be the bigger man. Miyagi and Johnny are not afraid to reprimand their students or to make sure that they stay grounded and focused, but also forgive them. Miyagi had done this during training with Daniel on teaching him how to punch, and Daniel would let his arrogance get the best of him. Miyagi would also do this in Karate Kid 3 when Daniel would be seduced by Silver's promise to teach him to get the better of Mike Barnes. Despite his angry outbursts at Mr. Miyagi and lying to him as well, Mr. Miyagi forgives Daniel and continues to be a mentor to Daniel up until his death. We also see this with Johnny. At the All Valley Tournament, he vocalizes his issue with Hawk and Miguel fighting dirty and injuring their opponents. He realizes the fault of his teachings and not being clear on the principles of Cobra Kai. Throughout Season 2, he vows to correct these in a number of ways, teaching the students to move forward, to show mercy through good judgment calls, and also bonding more with Miguel, especially teaching Miguel the difference between mercy and honor. After finding out that Miyagi-Do was trashed by the students of Cobra Kai, he forces the students to do burpees until one of them breaks and admits they were responsible, saying that bullshit we don't teach in here, further proving his intention that he wants to be more honorable and set that example for his students. Unfortunately, another similarity that Miyagi and Johnny also share is that they both had trauma occur in their lives that in the end led them to be better people. Mr. Miyagi would be plagued by the loss of his son and wife for many years, and although during the entire franchise we see him only go into a drunken depression once, we can speculate that this happened many other times we just didn't see on screen. Speaking from personal experience as someone who has PTSD, trauma can stay with you for a very long time, and can be deeply rooted to the point to where it still hurts just as it did the first time. This is evident with Mr. Miyagi in Karate Kid 1. Johnny also has his own trauma he deals with, the death of his mother, his strained relationship with his son, and also his self-doubt of not being a good enough sensei to Miguel and other Cobra Kai, especially after having a sensei like Kreese who almost choked him to death. Johnny also copes with this by drinking. Although not at all a recommended way to cope with trauma, this is something that he and Miyagi both do. We also don't know much of Johnny's life that occurred between Karate Kid 2 and the birth of Robbie, so there may be other demons that he's fighting as well. The last thing that makes Johnny much more like Miyagi is broken up into two parts. The pact they make with their students and their straightforward style of teaching. After taking Daniel to his dojo, Miyagi makes a sacred pact with Daniel, to be able to give it his all and not question his methods. He promises him to teach him karate as long as Daniel does what he asks. Johnny asks a very similar thing of Miguel when he brings back Cobra Kai. He asks Miguel that once he goes down this path there is no turning back, expecting that Miguel must be willing to give it his all, and in turn Johnny will teach him karate. Johnny also even tells Miguel at one point to not question his methods and that he's going to keep his part of the bargain. The way they both teach is very straightforward. Once Daniel moves past muscle memory, Miyagi is straightforward when teaching him to be able to balance physically, how to punch, how to do the drum technique, and also in learning kata. When Daniel does not show Miyagi immediately what he learns, Miyagi yells,
"Shut up!"
Very similar to how Johnny always yells,
"Go ahead!"
when he needs the student to focus. Johnny also teaches very straightforward when it comes to striking, headbutting, slithering, etc. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. Do you agree or disagree? If I missed anything, feel free to write that as well. This will probably be my last Cobra Kai video of 2020, but I have a few more videos planned in 2021. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, share it with your friends, give it a like, and please subscribe. As always, stay beautiful, stay awesome. We'll catch you around next time.